Hello, and welcome back to Fascination with lovely Anna.
Hi.
Hello, and myself. And we just went back to the first part, and what Doralee said was, I'm Doralee, the sexiest captain on the Paris-Miami flight. Ooh. Do you like suspense? Well, you're invited to spend a delicious weekend with me. Fasten your seatbelts. We're ready for takeoff. Yeah, and we already had the pleasure to see her under the shower. So, I think we did everything we had to do in this room. We hid our vial, which will become important. And now let's go down. I hope I didn't forget anything here, but then I can come back here, I guess. Yes.
But why is she needing to get the vial? I mean, is she's some secret agent or something like this?
Yes, I think she is. At least in this game, she is.
We never
really knew what she was in Lost in Time. We know that she inherited this big mansion in the Normandy, but we never learned anything about her profession.
Yeah, okay.
So maybe we'll find something downstairs, she said. Oh yeah, we will. There is some newspapers. Let's glance through them. The Miami Tribune. They talk about Mr. Nichols dying on the plane. Oh. And we have one news. Okay. We'll have to collect 6 news. I hope I don't miss any. And there is a nice magazine. Hi, guys.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. And somewhere, there is a torn corner. And there's a telephone number, which I will have to write down, of somebody called Lou Dale, whoever that is. We don't know that yet.
674.
674. And the rest we don't know yet. Okay. All right. So
this game is done by a woman, yes?
This game was developed by a woman, yes.
Yeah, very strange.
you have to feed the trolls and the market, and you know how things go. There is something... Can you see what I mean about pixel hunting?
Yeah, the key ring. Let me guess, these are about 6 pixels?
If even that many, I would guess 2 or 3. It's more on here, so let's just take the key ring and let's search the lobby some more. Hey, there is a dead cigarette butt, but we cannot take that. It would be too short anyway. But there is a token, and tokens always come handy in adventure games, don't they?
Okay.
Larry uses tokens all the time. No, he steals quarters. At least in Larry 5.
Ah, yeah, I remember.
And now we can always see our inventory, which I think is quite nice. So we have token, we have one news, and we have a key ring.
Yay.
And we have the number, or half the number, of somebody called Lou Dale. Do you see this? Is Isalinda. She's
Isalinda.
5 pixels high, and she's a receptionist.
Oh my god!
Your part.
Oh. At your service, Ms. E. I can't stop to smile. And look at my teeth.
She's white. So beautiful. Now, I don't want to give her the token, but I wanted to show her the key ring.
Oh, yeah, please. Oh, it's the key tag for a locker in the changing booth. It must have come off. Here's the key that goes with it. You can leave your clothes if you go to the pool. What? Oh my god, we have a pool.
By any chance, did we ever get dressed again? I don't even know. Okay. And what I found out only at the end of this game, that she is a helpful person and we can show her all kinds of objects and she always gives us hints if we need them.
Oh, that's very nice of her.
Yeah, isn't it? And now we have a key and maybe, I don't know what happens if we show her the news. No, thanks. Okay, she has no hint for us. I think that is about.
About all?
No, I think we. Wait a minute. There must be another. There must be another. Yeah,
Another.
I knew I forgot something because there is a very, very important phone number which we need. I'll take it down. Jeffrey Miller, the one who wasn't available on the phone earlier.
Ah, yeah, Quantum Unlimited Labs. Yeah, I remember.
Exactly. And here is his personal line. That's J. Miller. Yeah, Miller. That is 666. No, I'm sorry.
Three, three, three.
Yes,
Nine, 9, 9, 9.
9, 9.
Nine.
Okay. And he weighs $500 million. Well, with the nowadays recession, that's not too much anymore. But still more than I have. Unfortunately, we can't take the flowers and we cannot look at the picture and we cannot walk upstairs. So let's just go back to the room and give that Jeffrey Miller guy a phone call and find out what he has to tell us. So that it was 1, 2, 3, and then 4 times 9, 1, 2, 3, 4. And let's see what they say. And if he's there, and what he has to tell us. And a phone is ringing, and. Oh, good morning, Miss Dora. Delighted to hear from you. I heard what happened in your plane. Poor old Fayard. Fortunately, you have the vial. Above all, keep it somewhere safe. Well, we already did that. Don't carry it with you. No, we hid it already. I'll explain the whole business. Then we'll think things over. Come and meet me at the office. The entry code for the building is, and that is C.
C3217.
Okay, building.
What happens if we carry along the vial? Did you try that?
No, I didn't try that, but I think then we might die. I died quite a bit in this game.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I think maybe as soon as we leave the hotel, somebody might kill us.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, and it says game over. If I remember one place where this happens, of course I'll show it. Okay, so now we have the code for the building, but before we go there, the vial is safe. The phone is ringing again. Well, Dora, guess what? Guess who's just in time to save you from an interminable evening with some clumsy, pretentious bore? I'm talking about Robert de la Cafetiere. You know what? You should read Doralice.
Rob, what are you doing here?
Well, I fly the old crate here from Mexico twice a week these days. Come down and have a drink at the pool and we'll talk, baby.
Oh, at the pool. Okay,
Yeah,
are you into naked boss?
wow, look at this handsome
Oh.
hunk of a guy. Hi,
Oh, my.
Dora, my darling little firefly. Haven't crashed your plane yet? When will you marry me?
Oh my God. Oh my God. You're
Ha
mocking me. You old macho. Why should I make one man miserable when I can make a lot of men happy?
Oh, she's so right
Oh
about this.
my
Well,
God.
yeah, don't worry. I adore you anyway. And do you love me?
I love all men.
He looks like Humphrey Bogart. Slurp, enough slurping. So that's enough. Before there's Prisca and there is Sharon.
They are into naked,
Well, she's
swimming.
topless and but she wears a swimsuit, so that's okay. But she's tending the bar and she should be properly dressed as well. Let's talk to Prisca first.
Robert, you know Prisca. She's my chief hostess.
Yes, of course. I remember the garden party in Rio. Crazy. Hi, Prisca.
Hi, Robert. Hey, Dora. Did you know I was asked about the death on the plane off at the airport? A man in a wheelchair with a cat.
What's all
this
about?
That's a strange combination.
Yes, very. What's all this about? Are you murdering your passengers these days? That's her. That's you.
Nothing serious. A heart attack. Carry on, Prisca. I'm listening.
I managed to get this flashlight off him and a pendant I dropped somewhere around here. It's stupid, I can't find it anymore. And it's important because if we don't have it later on, we can never get it back. So we better go and look for it. But first, so I had to restart the game again. Nearly at the end, that was annoying.
Oh no.
And here we have a flashlight with no battery in it. There is writing on it, but it's illegible. Okay, we'll have to find a place to maybe translate it or clean it or whatever. We don't know that yet. And there is a hat hanging here, which we give to Prisca.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
Doesn't she look nice? Oh, thanks. She's so pretty.
Oh, yeah.
Because, yeah, we have to take the hat off because there is a half a pixel with a switch.
Oh, a switch, yeah.
And
switch.
You see the shining little cross here?
Oh, yeah.
That's the pendant shining on
there's the pendant, yeah.
bottom, which, of course, we take as some kind of a microphone. It's a microtransmitter. It looks damaged after it stay in the pool. Pity. I can't find out who was the receiver. Well, but we will find that out. So we have a lamp without batteries, and maybe somewhere in here we'll find some batteries. But first, let's talk to the waitress.
No, Sharon.
Yes, what would you like to drink? And we have to choose coffee for one certain reason.
Oh, why?
Because, we need the sugar.
Okay.
We take one sugar and we put another one in the coffee and then we stir it. That's not really necessary to do, but I think that's a nice idea. And we can drink the coffee and are done. Of course, we can order a nice drink.
Yeah.
Hey.
Pina colada.
Yeah. And we drink the pina colada.
Mm.
And unfortunately, we can't get the straw or the lemon or orange, whatever it was.
What about another pina colada?
No, you won't get a second pina colada, dear Doralise. You have to stay sober. Oh. Before we end this episode, we take a look at the booth. And this, what was her name at the reception? I already forget. Isalinda, whatever.
Yeah.
She was kind enough to give us the pool key. And so we use the key on the keyhole. Surprise, surprise.
Oh, there's something inside. A Walkman. Wow.
This is a very antique game, yes.
Yeah.
It's a broken Walkman. No point in taking it. But there is a battery compartment and we have a token. Haha. So we can just take the batteries and put them automatically in our lamp.
Ah, yay.
Yay, wonderful. So that's that. And now we can leave the booth, go back to the pool. Can we, is there anything else? Yes. No, nothing else we can ask her. But we keep in mind that she told us about the strange guy in the wheelchair with a cat.
Yeah.
And maybe we'll meet that strange guy in the wheelchair with a cat. And one of the next episodes. Who knows? So stay tuned and you'll see more of Doralise. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.